Hey guys, it's Chris. From a slimy fish with teeth to birds with giant balls, here are 10 of the weirdest animals ever. Number 10, Dumbo Octopus, the umbrella animal. Have you ever seen an animal that looks like Disney's infamous elephant, Dumbo, and an umbrella at the same time? The Dumbo octopus is just that animal. The animal belongs to the genus of deep-sea umbrella octopuses. Skin webs connect its arms so that the octopus looks like an umbrella when it spreads its arms. But you can't use this umbrella to protect your skin from the rain. The octopus also has fins resembling ears shooting out from two sides of its head, a feature that has a striking resemblance with the Disney elephant's enormous ears. They have the same name too, which makes us wonder who got named after who. Or is it a coincidence that the octopus and elephant are both called Dumbo? Dumbo loves to stay in the deepest parts of the ocean, about 13,100 feet deep or more. Unlike other octopuses, this animal doesn't possess any ink sac. Its ear-like fins, however, help it navigate through the water. Dumbo's love for the extreme depths of the ocean means it has to live a life dominated by freezing weather and a lack of sunshine. But the environmental conditions don't perturb the octopus because it's adapted quite well. Females store up sperm for long periods after mating. They also always have eggs that are at different stages of development. When the environment is conducive to reproduction, the octopus transfers the sperm to its most fertile egg. The cycle continues as the females lay more Dumbo octopus eggs by attaching them to hard surfaces at the bottom of the ocean. Number 9. Hagfish, the slime fish. Called the most disgusting sea creature, the hagfish lives in cold waters ranging from shallow to deep ends. It's a boneless, jawless fish that looks like an eel. The hagfish has two rows of keratin tooth-like structures, which it uses to dig into the carcass of its prey. To feed, it attaches itself to live or dead fish, and then bores its way into the skin, consuming it from the inside out. It also ties its tail into knots to increase the force of its bite. As a defense mechanism against predators and fish that want to eat its meal, hagfish produces slime. This transparent sticky goo can fill up a 5-gallon container in a few minutes. While the enemy is still trying to spit out the slime, the hagfish slides away to safety. As repulsive as this animal seems, it has unique abilities. The hagfish can survive for months without food. Its skin can absorb nutrients. It also helps the sea recycling process when it feeds on carcasses and serves as food for other brave slime-defying fish. Number 8. Tarsier, the animal with eyes larger than its brain. Large eyes appear cute to anyone. With bulging eyes that are larger than its brain, the tarsier shares a weird resemblance to Smeagol in Lord of the Rings. Now imagine having a goggle that enhances night vision. You can navigate your way around in the darkness. Besides, you wouldn't bump into objects that could cause significant harm. The benefits a human gets from wearing night vision goggles are what the tarsier gets from having bulging, huge eyes. Although it can't see so many colors, the Southeast Asian animal can see well in the dark. Also, a tarsier has elongated hind limbs that aid its movement through the forest. Stranger still, it can rotate its round head 180 degrees. How cool is that? Number 7. Ribbon worm, the worm with the strange tongue. Found underwater in cold terrestrial areas in Taiwan, the ribbon worm can be 1 centimeter or grow as long as 60 centimeters. That's longer than the whale. The worm's central nervous system has hemoglobin, which makes it look red or pink. The ribbon worm has a proboscis, a feeding tube that looks like a tongue. When hunting, it releases the tongue-like structure that lets out a mucus-like secretion to paralyze its prey. The worm will then swallow it whole. It can swallow prey 3 to 4 times fatter. Some species use their proboscis to anesthetize their food and eat the delicacy inside out. The proboscis acts as a defense mechanism against predators. Although these creatures look cute, some species of ribbon worm are poisonous and they taste really bad. Number 6. Pangolin, the armored anteaters. If you see a pangolin, you would think it's related to an armadillo. Its beady eyes and big feet make it look cute. However, a pangolin is a mammal that looks like a reptile because scales cover its body. You might as well call this land animal the armored anteater since its food consists of larvae, termites, and ants. It has no teeth and uses its sticky tongue that can grow longer than its body to pick up its food. So then what's the use of its scales? The pangolin doesn't want predators to hurt its delicate skin, so it curls up into a ball when attacked. The scales give its enemies a hard time. Unfortunately, a pangolin's predator consists of humans too, and scales won't help it this time. The animal is rapidly getting extinct in its home continents of Africa and Asia. Governments have created international laws and treaties to stop the illegal hunting and poaching of pangolins. Number 5. Star-nosed mole, the world's fastest eater. Remember Joey Chestnut, the greatest eater of all time? There's an animal that can give him a run for his money, the star-nosed mole. Its star-shaped nose looks like the underside of a tiny octopus. Although the underground animal is almost blind, it can sense and eat its food in a quarter of a second. With each touch of the mole's nose, more than 100,000 nerves send signals to the brain. That's 5 times more nerve fibers than the human hand. The star-nosed mole might come across as ugly to most people, but what it lacks in looks, it makes up for with its numerous talents. It can touch 10 different places in less than a second. It can even smell underwater by blowing out air bubbles and drawing them right back into its nose. Number 4. Yeti crab, the animals with hairs that serve an unusual purpose. If you happen to be a very hairy person and think you don't have things going well for you in the waxing department, just wait till you meet the yeti crab. It's got its arms and legs covered in hair. We might as well call this crab royalty too, as it's named after the Polynesian goddess of shellfish. The yeti crab pitches its abode in warm waters of about 380 degrees Celsius, a conducive environment for its bizarre feeding habits. The crab places its hairy arms over the warm water vent openings to catch bacteria in its hair bristles. Once the bacteria matures, yeti eats them up. So the crab's hairy body isn't for nothing. It helps in growing and harvesting food. Do you want to see a yeti crab in its strange feeding style? Hop into a submarine and dive into the Pacific Ocean for a friendly visit. Number 3. Walking stick, the insect that looks like a twig. What's the first thing that crosses your mind when you hear the name walking stick? Is it a device that aids walking? A walking stick is actually an insect in the Phasmatodea family. And no, this particular stick doesn't help you walk. Just as its name suggests, the insect looks like a stick with tiny leafless branches serving as legs. The walking stick lives in every continent except Antarctica. It's similar to the chameleon because it can camouflage as plant material. It can even sway back and forth in motion, a mechanism that makes the insect look like a twig tossed around by the wind. Camouflaging is the walking stick's most potent defense mechanism. But when blending in with the environment doesn't work, some species emit a foul smell to confuse their predator, or secrete a liquid that can blind the enemy temporarily. These invertebrates are stick insects, the class of the biggest insects in the world. They can grow from 1 to 12 inches depending on the species. Females usually grow taller than the males and can lay unfertilized eggs that hatch into new female walking sticks. Number 2. Harp sponge, the beautiful immobile carnivore. If you were a sea creature with a great love of music, how would you form your band? What if you needed a stringed instrument? How would you get it? One sea creature fits that role perfectly, the harp sponge. Living on the seafloor about 10,000 feet below the surface, the animal looks like a broad-stringed harp and doesn't share the slightest resemblance with a sponge. The delicate look of this creature that could be termed the world's most beautiful sponge doesn't make it any less dangerous to its prey. The 3-foot-wide harp sponge is rooted to the seafloor. However, it immobilizes its prey once it snags it. Using tiny hooks in its filament, it dismantles its food cell by cell and absorbs it. But that's not where the weirdness of the harp sponge stops. How does it breathe in oxygen? It takes in water, absorbs the oxygen in it, and filters out bacteria. Its process of fertilizing its eggs is even stranger. The sponge treats sperm as prey, dismantling and absorbing them into the eggs. The harp sponge might have bizarre methods of surviving and reproducing, but if you're a carnivorous, immobile creature living at the bottom of the sea, you might have no other choice. Number 1. Greater sage grouse, the grand courting birds. What the heck is this? The greater sage grouse is the largest grouse in North America. Like the beautiful sage leaves that comprise most of its diet, the bird comes in lovely color combinations. The male sage grouse has a black belly, white breast, and a dark brown throat. It also has a yellow patch on its eye, but its most distinctive feature is 2 yellowish neck sacs that puff up to enormous proportions. And this is very attractive to the females. The female greater sage is speckled brown and gray, with a dark belly and light brown throat. This animal possesses a long tail that resembles the peacock's tail just a little. The spectacular thing about this bird isn't just its colors, or the fact that it's found only in the sagebrush country of the West. The Greater Sage's Courtship Display is an entertaining event that showcases the dynamics of the male-female coupling. Before most human love relationships begin, ladies make themselves visually appealing to attract guys. But these birds do the opposite. In spring, the sage-grouse males come together in a group called a lek. The most dominant or alpha male takes the coveted position in the middle. The birds beside him are a little less dominant or beta males. This reduction in hierarchy continues as the birds get to the outer edges of the formation. The greater sages gather on the dancing ground, which can be a field, meadow, or even the roadside. The sole purpose of the dance is to entice females to mate with them. They puff out their chests, spread their spiky tails, inflate those two yellowish sacs on their neck, and strut around to catch the eyes of the females. Females come to the display hoping to have a good time. Have you seen any high school movies where all the girls swoon for one guy? Well, something similar happens here. The greater sage-grouse females want the strongest and most dominant male. All they have to do is look at the middle of the dancing formation and voila, they've identified their desired male. About 80% of the females mate with the alpha male, and the others make do with the beta male or a few other birds that are almost as strong as the alpha. Soon the sages lay eggs. The mothers build nests for them and incubate them for 25 to 27 days. Within a week or two after hatching, the young sage grouses can fly for short distances. Thanks for watching. If you do come across any of these animals, you might want to maintain a safe distance while admiring their weird beauty. Which of these animals did you find the most intriguing? Let me know in the comments and press that subscribe button if you're new here. I'll see you next time.